avoid the use of strobes and atmospheric effects. Heating time supports an entirely smoke-free environment. Smoking is prohibited inside the castle. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy the tournament.
For thousands of years, mankind has marked milestones in his history. These were all occasions accompanied by displays of power and pageantry. Today, events such as a royal wedding, political conventions, even high school graduations are reminiscent of the great spectacles of the distant past. Pageantry lay at the center of the medieval tournament. Medieval Times seeks to recreate the electrifying atmosphere that would have been yours if you had journeyed to a tournament 1,000 years ago.
Silence! Silence, I say. Indeed, I need silence to speak. But how are we to arrange a tournament unless we know who is to attend? Where is my Lord Marshal? Chancellor, attend me at once. Your Grace, you summon me, sire.
I'm Lord Chancellor, is the news of the Lord Marshal.
There's indeed, Your Grace. The Marshal has just returned from his journey. I should join you here in just a moment. Lord Marshal!
Indeed, Your Grace, and there is much news of the realm. Not very well, we shall speak of it later.
For now, what news have you in answer to my invitation?
Joyous news, sire. For six of the finest knights of the realm have agreed to compete in your tournament.
And news indeed, Lord Marshal. Well done.
And what of another
lady
of the kingdom? How else then?
All shall attend, my lady. The knights, the noble lords and ladies, and the retainers. All shall make the journey to cheer their champions to victory.
Joyous news indeed, Your Grace, but such a gathering requires a feast.
So, but a feast for so many.
We must begin to prepare. Lord Chancellor, see to rooms in London in the style to which our guests are accustomed. And summon the Master Falconer. Tell him to send his hunting bird aloft, for we shall require much game to load the tables. And summon to me who keeps the wine cellars. Fire guests shall be thirsty.
Thirsty indeed, my lady. And you, Lord Marshal,
Your Majesty.
My guests will require stables for their horses and mules for their ox. Have the blacksmith stand by to ready their lances for the joust and polish armor for the tournament, for my guests will be far too tired after such a long journey.
As you command, sire.
And now to your office, my lord. How fair my armor is.
We are well prepared, my lord. I have had the finest smiths working hard at the anvils, crafting weapons for the combat. Rest assured, sire, the knights could ask for no finer arms in all the realm.
It is well done. And now, my lord, take your leave and see to the final preparations.
Your Majesty.
Indeed, so much to do. Yet the flower of chivalry shall grace us this day, my lady.
And I shall be pleased that so many ladies shall share my company.
Just a moment spent in a medieval castle. The first castles were simple forts that were built with wood and then later fortified with stone. You can still see many of these stone giants standing throughout modern-day Europe. Silent sentinels to an age of chivalry. Who lived inside a castle? Well, a great and powerful nobleman. His immediate family, his loyal knights, and his most trusted advisors. Outside the castle lived the farmers and herdsmen, whose duty it was to tend to the crops and livestock of the liege lord. In the event